We're technically in evergreen, but a good bit north at about 8,500 feet of elevation near the base of Mount Evans. So now you live over by the mailboxes. Mm-hmm. Huh? Mm-hmm. And where do you live?
I live next to Old Elle's house. You know, where Sally lives, and then the cabin, and the log house, and then we're the gray house.
But these cabins were all part of an effort back in the 1930s. Back in the time of the Depression, actually, there was an effort done by the government to help people get jobs called the Civilian Conservation Corps. So it's kind of relevant to now, right? Finally, one day I was looking at it, and I was like, oh, it wants to be a library.
My daughter loves coming here.
All sorts of Barbies.
I bought this property about a year and a half ago, and it was kind of just a falling apart little cabin. But I had a vision for it that it could be something that could help tie the community together, because we're all great neighbors up here, but we needed some place to help us gather. So I renovated it, worked on it, restored it, and turned it into a library.
It looks really old.
I know, but that's the best kind.
So that neighbors could come and they could put their books in there and share them with our other neighbors, and we could talk about the books that we shared and gather during the winters and have a place to talk.
Every time we come in, there's something new and different.
Yeah, I know.
We need to take lemons when we get them and make lemonade. And that may sound cliche and, you know, Pollyanna-ish. And if it does, you know, I don't care. Because I think when it all comes down to it, our happiness and joy is based on how well we can do that, how well we can take the lemons and make lemonade.
When COVID hit, and the libraries closed, and the kids up here had nowhere to go, and everyone was trying to figure out how to keep a sense of community in spite of having to social distance.
We have this wonderful library here, this little library, the free library for the neighborhood. And Mary, who started the library, has been kind enough and gracious enough to let me feature my book in here.
It may only be about 12 foot by 8 foot, but it's big enough to hold the heart of our community.
What I've learned from this pandemic is that we all have to be very flexible and be willing to be fluid in our plans and our goals and expectations.
I think it's just one more thing to help us all get to know each other and understand each other and share the things we love with each other as a neighborhood.
It's a lot about forgiveness, inspiration, grace, love, compassion.
It's almost like you can feel a spirit in the air that just makes us feel good that we're something to pull us all together in a time where everything's trying to push us apart.
As we all know, all of our lives shifted and changed.
We have our books and we have the things we love, and it's big enough to share them. And that's really what matters.